Welcome viewers to a brand new series, Europa Universalis 4. I've been playing this game for the past couple of months and I am hooked. This game is pretty amazing because it kind of combines several things I love in, well, it's kind of like side hobbies, I guess you could say. I love history and I love like playing around in the world and playing around with history and alternate histories. I mean, back when I used to play Civilization, I used to always love playing on world maps and effectively starting off as a small nation and conquering the world. But this game takes it to a next level. You're playing on the world, starting year 1444 to the year 1821. You're going to pick any country in the entire world. In fact, you can even create a custom nations, and there's actually a few achievements linked to custom nations. And you simply try to play it out for 350 years, something like that. 80 years? I can't remember exactly. It's a decent amount of time. It doesn't sound that long, but it's actually quite a long time. Now, the game name does suggest it's Europe-centric, and it sort of is, but I think the developers, Paradox, they actually did a pretty good job balancing it for the rest of the world. And here's what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to be doing achievement runs. Now, achievements in this game are actually pretty difficult. For one thing, they all require you to be on Iron Man mode, which to me is not a big deal. And two, they generally require you to start in slightly awkward positions and try to get out of it. But here's the thing, no matter what nation you start as, you're going to be facing challenges all the way through. As a small nation, as an emerging, growing nation, and as an empire, you're going to be facing issues from a lot of places. I mean, to a certain point, you do kind of grow so big that opponents become trivial, but it takes a lot of effort to get to that point. So without further ado, let me introduce what we're actually going to be doing. So, single player, and I am going to be starting as this nation here. Kara, let's try to get it out. Kara Kunulu. Kunulu. It's actually often known as QQ because you can see QQ. But yeah, we're going to start as Kara Kunulu. It's a relatively medium to large sized nation in the Middle East. In fact, you can see this is roughly where Iraq is, this is Armenia, etc. And over here, we're bordering the giant Timurid Empire. The Ottomans are taking over everything, and they are going to be a big challenge. And this campaign is going to be about Persia. Now, how does Persia fit into this? I mean, you can't even see Persia on the map. Well, Persia is modern Iran. It used to be called Persia, and actually was known by Europeans as Persia up until like 1914. 1918-ish. But the point is, what does this have anything to do with Persia? Well, Persia doesn't exist at this point in time, and what we're going to do is form Persia. And there's an achievement called This Is Persia, which, for those who get cultural references, it's kind of referring to This Is Sparta. Specifically, it's referring to two incredibly embarrassing defeats to the Persian Empire by the Tyno city-states of Greece at the time, around 480 BC. First to King Darius, and second time to his son, King Xerxes. So, this achievement will be about three things. Number one, form Persia. That's kind of given. Number two, retake most of the Persian Empire. That includes Anatolia, the Ottomans. That's going to be a huge challenge. And number three, avenge the ancient kings of Persia and take out Greece. What we also have to deal with, of course, as well, is we're surrounded by a lot of other emerging empires. Muscovy up here is going to be forming Russia. We got the Polish Lithuanian Commonwealth, which will be forming a rather large empire by himself. We got the Mamluks to its south, and Timurids to our right, which we actually have to try to swallow up most of his land. So that's going to be pretty tricky. You can see how large they are compared to us. But I think I said enough. Let's get to it. Iron Man mode, of course. And we'll record this. Persia. But let's call this This Is Persia. Start Iron Man. Cool. There's actually a second achievement linked to the Karakun as well. And the second achievement is called Baba Black Sheep. And that's because Karakun is also known as the Black Sheep Turkmen. You can kind of see it in their icon, sort of, if you see that as a sheep. But basically, this achievement involves being the world's leading producer in wool. Now, wool is actually kind of a worthless resource as far as trade goods go, but it's an achievement attached. Let's do it. So first things first, I've actually had a very brief look prior to starting this campaign. And also, for those who haven't played this game before, I'm sorry, this might be really confusing. It took me like several games before I finally got a hang of how this game actually works. Because this game is actually really complicated, just like Stellaris. They're both made by Paradox. Paradox is pretty good at making these stupidly complicated games. But first things first, anyway, what I'm actually going to do, you can see here, Unrest 14.7. Unrest 15.7. Basically, all this land here is shit. That's pretty much a nice way of putting it. Reason is, they are Armenian, not this one. Which one? Here, Armenian. And also Coptic. Coptic is a religion. It's actually a sect of Christianity. Nowadays, it's mostly based around here in Egypt, Ethiopia, and I think there's a few small countries around here, such as Armenia. But we, on the hand, we are Muslims. We are specifically Shia Muslims, surrounded by, let me actually show you, we are Shia, surrounded by Sunni. I'm looking at giant. I mean, it's Orthodox over here, Catholic over there, Hindus and Virginia, and etc. etc. Confused over there in China. We can actually see a lot of the map right now because we're in a very central location. So, first things first, because these guys are not our religion and aren't an accepted culture, they don't particularly like us being their rulers. So, what I'm actually going to do, this is suggested by the wiki, and I can certainly see why. I'm going to release him as a vassal. Now, vassals, I could release Persia as a vassal, but we're not going to do that because I want to become Persia. So Armenia, they'll receive Yerevan, Nakhchivan, and Van. So Yerevan, Van, and this one here. So let's release Armenia, they'll become our vassal. And yes, that's fine. Our subjects, they have 32% liberty desire, that's fine. These other lands aren't nearly as bad. Okay, this one is also Armenian. Why didn't this get given to... this actually has a lot of development, 12, whereas these three provinces, they're not bad. They're actually not bad provinces, just that if we keep them, it's going to kind of suck having to deal with the unrest. This one's actually not too bad, it's only 5.9. The thing is, I don't want to have to deal with unrest, because the thing is, if you have unrest in provinces, they end up rebelling, and rebels are annoying. Especially since, look at here, see this brown? These are all mountains, and we are actually a horde. A horde is... And again, I'm sorry, I'm kind of like pummeling you with information here for those who have actually played this. Hordes are really good at fighting flat ground. They're kind of like... Think of like the Mongols. In fact, most of these nations up here are all hordes. They're great at fighting flat ground, but it sucks fighting in mountains, which is unfortunate because most of Persia, most of Iran, is mountains. It's going to suck taking this over, but we're going to do it. I could give these two provinces to Armenia. And what I'm actually going to do as well is they're Coptic. They're going to hate me for this. I'm going to enforce religion. They're going to hate me so much for this. It's going to take forever for them to like me again, but that's okay. So now I force them to become Shia just like us, and they're going to start converting these provinces for me, so that would be great. And I think I am going to keep... actually, how much liberty desire will be removed if I do this? 6% and mush? Belongs to a tribe, that would be bad. Okay, I think I'll leave them as it is. Let's have a look at other unrest. Oh wow, most of our problems are pretty bad. We could actually release Iraq down here as well. I can see here Iraq considers this. Iraq doesn't exist at this point in time. We could release Iraq, but I'm not going to. I think for now, let's just release Armenia. These are all flat ground provinces, not too bad. It is tempting to give these two to Armenia as well, but I think I'll keep them for now just for the extra development. Development being how well developed provinces. So you got tax development, you got production development, and you got manpower development, which corresponds to money, money and trade goods, and trade power, and manpower. Manpower being people you can use to send to war. Okay, so that's done. Next thing I'm going to do is create rivals. Okay, so apparently, Ottomans have rivaled us, so that's lovely. Lithuania has rivaled us, so that's interesting. And Georgia has rivaled us. Oh, Georgia, okay, you are being... You're guaranteed the independence of Trebizond. Trebizond is this country down here. How about you guys? How are you guys feeling? You've rivaled Shamar. Shamar is these guys and Hussar. So these two have rivaled each other. The easiest land we can take right now is actually this land down here, because all flat land are provinces, and being a horde, we get this lovely cause of war. So basically in this game, you can't just declare war on a whim, unless you're a horde. And that's what I love about hordes, is that if you're a horde, you can just declare war over this cause of war called Trouble Feud, and it's just amazing. So what we're gonna do is, I think, take over these provinces, and also we need to look for allies. So first, Ottomans hate us, that's fine because we are going to rival them right back. Next, Lithuania has rivaled us, that's fine. We're gonna rival them right back as well. Why? Because Lithuania often ends up falling in a personal union with Poland. What personal unions are is kind of like they end up sharing the same ruler, and that's because Poland gets a special event to get a personal union over Lithuania, which is kind of crazy. But that's fine, because when that happens, Lithuania will no longer be our rival, we get a heap of power projection. And again, I know I'm just throwing terms at you here, just bear with me here. So I'm going to rival Georgia. What choice do we have? Mamluks? Timurids? I think we do want to take out Georgia. Georgia is going to suck to fight them, but it won't be too bad. We could fight them in these flatland provinces here. If we could beat their army, it'll be pretty good. So let's rival Georgia right back. And I'm going to rival Lithuania right back. Now, who likes us? This is the next question. Mamluks. Okay, Mamluks, you don't seem to like me. Neighboring heretic religion. Yeah, about that. Yeah, like I said, we are a Shia nation in the midst of a huge sea of Sunni. So a lot of people aren't going to like us. None of you like me. Oh, Hassa actually likes me. Well, in that case, Hassa, I don't really want to do anything with you. Wow, you guys really don't like me. Wow, you want my provinces. Of course you do. So, is there anyone here who actually likes me? Crimea likes me. Yay, Crimea likes me. That's awesome. Not really, actually. Crimea often ends up being swallowed by either Poland or Great Horde or Genoa. So that's not great. But, and also they can't really help me with my biggest problem. And my biggest problem is I want to be able to take on the Ottomans as soon as possible. Byzantine, yes, Byzantium is still alive here. Constantinople is a tiny little, well, I guess you could say peninsula in a sea of Ottomans. So it's not great for them. Karaman does not like us. Ramazan does not like us. Okay, we're basically, none of our neighbors like us, except Shamar. Hassa, who doesn't... Okay, never mind, you're hostile to me. That's lovely. Okay, so no one likes us. Maybe it wasn't such a great idea starting as Karakun, but hey, this is great. We can try expanding several directions. I think, like I said, this is the easiest land I can expand into because it's all desert. Desert is flat ground, which means we have a huge advantage against these northern horde nations. We can also try expanding north towards Great Horde, Nogai, Kazan. And because there's a lot of flat land around here, so that's quite easy. We can also try to expand eastwards, try to expand towards Asia. That could also be good. But I do want to take on Timurids and Ottomans. I know there's not a lot of action going on. I apologize again. Okay, this is tricky. Who do I actually want to have friends and who do I want to be our rivals? Whilst right now, we only have one possible alliance, I could just take it. It's a terrible idea. Well, who's your rivals? You rival Lithuania. How about this? Okay, they're my rivals. Who are your rivals? Your rivals are Mamluks. So we have a common rival, Mamluks. Do I want to take over your land? Yes, I do. I do want to take over Mamluks' land at some point, but I'm pretty sure the Mamluks are much more powerful than me right now. But I do want to take over your land at some point. Ooh, okay. Yeah, okay. So that's not happening anytime soon, is it? Karaman... It's not that bad. We could try to rival Karaman, but Karaman often ends up being swallowed by the Ottomans. What I also really want to make sure I can do is expand quickly this way to try to stop the Ottomans from getting too much territory. It will put us in conflict with the Ottomans very quickly as well, which is why I want to get allies against the Ottomans as soon as possible. Does Poland like us? Okay, alliance. We're far away. So that's going to be tricky, but if I can get Poland to ally me, that would actually be really helpful. I wish I could see Hungary right here, but I can't see Hungary. Because Hungary is bordering the Ottomans directly, whereas Poland is not quite. Okay, I want to see if I can get Poland to like me. Because if I can get Poland to like me, who are they rival to? Okay, they actually don't care about Ottomans. That's unfortunate. That's really unfortunate. Great. So who should be our friends? I mean, yes, we look big, but we're not actually that big. Trust me. So, Cassia, do you hate me? Circassia. I mean, how many nations do how many provinces do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4. Not bad, but I do want to just. You guys are kind of easy food for me to feed on, so I don't really want to ally you. I kind of want to just expand this way. Okay, how about this? Crimea, we'll offer that alliance, because I do plan on expanding this way really quickly. I'm going to actually send my army. I actually have two stacks of 12 and 10. That's actually pretty impressive. I don't need these ships at all, so I'm going to get rid of these ships. Back, who wants to buy my ships? Timurids? You hate me. Okay, Hassa, I'll sell you some ships. What kind of ships do I have? I have one bark, four galleys, and six transports. So galleys are good at basically close sea areas like here, whereas barks are basically light ships and they're useful for mostly trading. Okay, so Hassa, can I sell you my ships? I'll sell you my bark. You don't want it. Why don't you want it? My ships are good. Fine, screw you too. How about you, Omar? Do you hate me? Well, you don't truly hate me. Okay, you're willing to buy my bark. Great. Speaking of which, trade. I could try and improve my trade power here. I mean, that's probably why I have a bark. I might actually keep that bark. In which case, what do I want to do with these things here? I don't really want the galleys or the cogs. How do I get rid of them? Tricky. Because no one really wants to buy them. How about we split them? Not, okay, oops, I don't mean split them. Okay, I'm going to take all the galleys. I'm going to try to sell them. And then I'm going to take all the transports. I'll see if I can sell them as well. Because I don't want them. Bukristan, will you buy my ships? No, you not really. Oman, will you buy my ships? Nope, the only thing you're willing to buy is my bark. The only thing I actually want to keep. Timurids, will you buy my ships? I think the answer is nobody wants my ships. How about Sindh? Will you buy my ships? you just buy this ship. I don't want to sell this ship, damn it! How about you? Who are you? Kathwa. Sell ships. Too far away. I could send my ships over here and try to sell them off. See who's willing to buy my ships. Ooh, Bahamas likes me. Well, that's good because I do plan on expanding into India. Especially this part of India. This part of India is really good. Once you go to this part of India, it kind of sucks. It's all jungle and stuff. But we could try expanding into India really quickly. But it requires us to go through Timurids first, so that's going to be hard. Okay, fine. Nobody wants my ships. I'm going to destroy them. I don't want these cogs. I don't want these galleys. And first thing we're going to do is declare war on Shammah. And I'm going to have you go and declare war on Georgia. Yes, I'm signing two wars this quickly. Chevron is rival to Gazukamaka. However you pronounce that. Gazikumak. I don't know. We could try taking on Chevron. Chevron is a really easy enemy. But I kind of want to take Georgia simply because they are our rival. How strong is Georgia? That's their only army. And this is almost like cheat mode, but it's not because it's built into a game. You can see how strong your enemies are before you even fight them. It's kind of silly in that regard. Georgia. Georgia. Georgia, Georgia, Georgia. Where are you? G. Yep, that's your entire army. So we'll send this over here. We'll need to get a few generals. In fact, what's our leader look like? Okay, how much money are we making? Okay, so I'm not going to hire any advisors for now because we simply don't have the money for it. Yeah, start two wars. What can possibly go wrong? So yeah, we're going to attack you. Actually, no, let's attack Chevron at the same time so we can keep our two armies roughly together. It's probably be a better idea. We can leave the Arabian Peninsula alone for a little while. Okay, so like I said, no advisors because they're too expensive. We can't afford them. Yep, don't care. Don't particularly care. Don't particularly care. Okay, next, missionaries. Oh, okay, so we have a huge number of Sunni provinces, a few Coptic provinces. This is not great. Who are you? Ardalan. Oh, I see. So you're the vassal under Timurids. Oh, okay. I didn't even know you existed. Okay, sure. So yeah, you go up here. Next thing is forts. Next thing we need to deal with is forts. As in, we don't want too many forts, if any. So what's our capital exactly? This is level 2, level 3. So this is our capital. I keep the fort our capital, but I'm going to get rid of this fort. We'll get rid of this fort, because it costs us stupid amounts of money. So that's a whole extra ducat. Ducat being the currency in the game. And I'm going to disable this fort, because we're not going to need it. it's still good to keep a 400 capital just in case. Since we're not going to clear war down here, I'm going to have you protect trade in the Persian Gulf. Which one do we want? How much trade power do we have here? Okay, let's try get more trade power here. That'll be good. Wait. What is our main node? I'm confused. Is this our main node? We earn 3.64. Oh, so that is our main node. Interesting. Huh. Well, I am slightly surprised that's our main node. That means we want to attack Tabaristan soon because they've got this thing right here. I'm surprised that's our main node, but I guess that works out for us. What I want to do soon is just move it up to either here or here, because these are much better nodes than these nodes here, but okay, sure. So, Tabaristan, you're currently... Oh, no one cares about you. Okay, well, let's not attack Chevron, let's attack you, and I'll take Georgia. Yeah, that's a plan. Okay, finally, we can probably do some action, maybe. So first, protect trade in the Persian Gulf, specifically in Basra. Next, I want to try to get Poland to like us. And lastly, we're gonna need him to declare war. No, we'll use him to declare war. We can't declare war until 11th of December. Why? I'm not actually sure. It's just something in the game. We have a lot of unrest in our provinces, so it actually might be worth hiring this guy here. National Unrest minus 2, just to avoid too many people hating us. Too many people rising up, because that would suck a lot. This thing hasn't updated yet because Fort Maintenance is about to go down to 0.5 instead of 4. Which means we can probably afford to hire one of you two, but I don't actually need any other of you two. Ideally, it will be a morale person, but we don't have a morale person. Morale makes a big difference in early game battles. Okay, is there anything else we want to do? Missions! Okay, Conqueror, G-U-R-I-A, Guria? Okay, sure. Improve relations with Chivran. Nope, I'm going to conquer them. Improve our prestige. That's going to take forever. We can form the Mughal Empire. We can unify Islam. Hey, we can actually try to do that. I think there's actually an achievement attached to that. Okay, form the Persian nations. We're going to try and do. Change religion to Sunni. Hell no. Establish whatever. Ruler has diplomatic skill at least 3. Oh, that's actually really good. Denouncement of sect practices. Okay, so getting that would be kind of good. Okay, we're going to conquer Guria. Guria, what kind of province is this? Georgian Orthodox. This is Armenian Coptic. Ooh, it's Coptic, interesting. And Armenia, I can try to give this to Armenia. How about you? All of these are Georgian Orthodox. Okay, let's do this. So, you're moving. We've taken the, we will take the mission, conquer Guria. And what next? Free and buy the slot, I know. Is anyone good here? Diplomatic recreation, don't care. Spy network construction, don't care. We hoard, we don't need spies. Trade efficiency, don't care. Is there anything else left to do? Yes, improve ancient Poland, doing that already. I want to get some more powerful allies around here. Unfortunately, Byzantium is not going to be a good ally. Benja, Mercuria. Hey, another Coptic nation. Fancy that. Okay, well, we could do with an ally on this side of the Timurids. Uzbek, no guy, no if you like me. Fair enough. Yarkand, you're a vassal, I believe. Yep, under Chagatai. Prakristan. In fact, is there any non-Sunni nations around here at all? I don't think there is there? I mean, you guys are Sunni. Sorry. Orthodox. Yeah, so we are like the only Shia nation. Are you Shia? Nope, you're Sunni. Oh, Hassa Shia. Hey, Hassa Shia. Okay. Hassa, you are tiny, you are pathetic, but would you like to be my friend for a while? Or we can just conquer you. That works too. Proof relations, offer alliance. You are hostile towards me. Well, that's nice, you're gonna be my friend anyway. Let's improve your relations for now. You're not a very useful ally though, that's a problem. I don't really want you to be my ally. You're a useless ally. If anything, Byzantium is actually one of the best allies we can get right now. Because he's actually in a position where he could be useful. If I can get one of these guys to my ally, it'd be kind of nice. Maybe, but then I kind of want to conquer the war quickly. So after we're done with this war with Georgia, I want to just be able to move here and start conquering all these nations. Okay, so now these guys can be allies. What I want to do then? Great Horde. I want to conquer you. I want to conquer all of you. Okay, Muscovy, let's turn you into an ally. That could be helpful. Improve relation. There. Done. Okay, we're finally moving forward. Okay, Crimea has accepted a military alliance. That's good. We are bigger than Crimea. That would be helpful when we try to take out Circassia. Maybe. We'll see, of course. You are moving that way. Let's turn our leader into a general. 1-2-1. Kind of terrible, but okay, we'll take it. Liberal desire is high. I know. I kind of forced you to be Shia. So naturally, they don't like me too much. I can triplicate them, but I'm not going to bother because this will tick down slowly over time. Cool. Speaking of which, are we over the force limit? No, we're not. We can actually still build a few more units. We have a little bit of money. Fort maintenance. Four. Yep, that's going to update. So I'm actually going to build a few more units. And tribes. Can we do anything with the tribes? Tribes and estate. They can contribute water. They can raise host. Okay, let's raise host. That's going to be really useful. Support tribes. That will make our cavalry cheaper. Cost me money, and then we can contribute warriors. We all need more warriors right now. You can give me a level 2 master recruiter, 50% cheaper. Gives you 50 influence. Okay. Manpower recovery speed is slightly increased. And we can actually hire him because he's cheap. Master recruiter. It costs 2 ducats a month. No thanks. I'm not paying that. Too expensive. I probably should also hire a second general. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, we raise host to get a general. Oh, that's such a shame. If that was 2-4, it'd be so much better. So basically, generals have pips. And pips in several categories. You can see here, he has 4 in this category, which is in fire. Fire is kind of useless at this point in the game. Shock is second one, which is basically melee. Or, you know, close combat. Maneuver is for maneuvering around terrain. So movement speed. And also crossing rivers and stuff. And siege as well. Siege. 2 siege, so that's pretty good. You are better than my leader. You, go over here. Have you got yourself any allies yet? Nope, you're trying to improve. Okay, Ireland's trying to improve your relations. Cool. That's fine by me. Okay. Decision, decision. Okay, that's nice. Chevron has entered a military alliance with Tabaristan. That's unfortunate. Ramazan has entered a military alliance with Mamluks. Ramazan. 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 Oh, you're Ramazan. You hold Adana. Okay, sure. Don't care. Georgia, have you got any allies? Trebizond. Okay, excellent. That is excellent because that means we can pull Trebizond into a. Wait, Trebizond? Who's Trebizond? Oh, okay, your trip is on. Interesting. Interesting, okay. Looks like you have to go there then. We're going to declare war on you, and we're going to be facing Trebizond and Georgia first. We're losing money. That's unfortunate, just barely. Despite the fact that we are 4 main and only 0.5. That's slightly unfortunate. You, be him. Okay, can we declare war yet? 11th. Okay, a few more days. You're guaranteed independent Trebizond if allied Trebizond. That's just weird. Why would you do that? That's horrible. I hate you. I hate you so much. Okay, that's fine. Whatever. Let's declare war now. So, Trebizond. You have... Trebizond has allied Georgia and Theodoro. Theodoro is more than irrelevant, but... Do I want to take over Trebizond right now? Yeah, why not? Theodoro. Theodoro. Yeah, we can take on take you on as well. So, Reconquest. Nope, we're not going to declare on that. We're going to declare on Tribal Conquest. Show superiority. We just have to win battles. And you are not willing to join us. That's fine. Don't care. What is the reason? You don't owe at least 10 favors. And you don't care about land. Yep, so we'll declare war on... Georgia, Trebizond will be pulled in as a co-belligerent, which means he'll call his own allies Theodoro. That is fine. I don't mind having Theodoro join the party, the more the merrier. Let's do this. Cool. So I'm not going to walk into a mountains here, because that'll be silly. Instead, let's split you in half. And we'll take over this territory for now. I'm going to keep the fort mothboard. Mothboard basically means the fort is non-functional. You're going to head that way, are you? Okay, that's fine. You can do that. We do have two generals after all, and we have two armies. Okay, that's a level 3 fort. That's kind of annoying, actually. Okay, you go over there. Heck, we have three armies right now. If they combine the armies, it's going to be kind of annoying, but I don't want to find them in the mountains, the thing. In fact, if they take over our vassal, Armenia, whatever, I guess. Armenia's producing infantry. Oh, that's good. Armenia right now is actually rather disloyal, which means they're not going to help us directly, but that's okay. We don't need them to help us directly. We'll have you go and start sieging down this fort. Level 3, wow. That's kind of annoying. Leave the cavalry behind. And here, shove the infantry here, because we're a horde. Basically, most nations can't just have pure cav armies, but being a horde, you can, because hordes are cool. Trade League disbanded, Trade League of Novgorod. Okay, sure, does not matter for me. It's completely irrelevant, in fact. Okay. So we go see trying the capital. It's not really how a horde fights, but the thing is, there's too much mountains here. It's really annoying. We have to get out of these stupid mountains. Advisor slot free. Yes, I know. Don't care. We'll have our king as a general. The thing about having your leader as a general is that if he dies, you get a stability hit. And being a general, you have a high chance of dying. And if you die in combat, you get a double stability hit. Stability is affects a lot of things, including unrest, amongst a lot of other things. Just take my word for it, I guess. Okay, let's see if we can go over here. I hate the fact that there's so much mountains over here, but just go over here for now. And we'll see if we can start looting. Yeah, that'll be a plan. Theodoro's actually stuck. No one's giving him military access. What's this? Royal Mansion from Crimea. Sure thing. Hey, look. We have a new Cameron, or how do we pronounce that? Which is, I believe, effectively the queen. Cool. Our heir is completely and utterly shit. The moment he turns 15, I'm going to see if I can turn him to a general. Because I want him to die. He's a horrible heir. Basically, leaders have points. So you can see here, military skill 4, diplomatic skill 2, administrative skill 2, and these correspond to how much you earn here every single month. Advisors increase it even further. And you can see here, our heir, when he comes of age and we actually becomes the leader, he's going to have 2-1-0. That is so terrible. So I actually want him to die. I could disinherit him, but it's going to give me a huge prestige hit, so I don't want to do that. But for now, because we aren't... It's actually kind of awkward finding them here. I wish there was less mountains over here. But, yeah, because of how awkward this is, I don't really want to engage them. I want them to come to me. So this is actually kind of awkward as far as Trouble Feud goes. Because normally Trouble Feuds, you just get out there, kill everyone, and then just be done with it. This is actually really awkward. Speed things up a little bit. Actually, slow things down again. Ottomans are still doing nothing. You're allied with Ragusa. Not sure why you would ally with Ragusa. Ragusa is a tiny one province country over there. Crimea is our ally. They are improving our opinion of them. That's great. Let's improve our opinion of them as well. Right back. And hopefully we can get an ally in Poland and Muscovy. Because I don't truly plan on expanding into Muscovy and Poland. Instead, most of our fighting will be around here. So they're kind of like a natural ally. Of course, we might end up having to deal with Muscovy's expansionist issues when Muscovy expands southwards. But that's going to be a different story, I guess. They're not even willing to fight us. This is kind of silly, actually. Come on. Let's speed things up a little bit. We have suffered casualties. Yeah, that's going to happen, isn't it? Yep. Okay. Ooh, what's this? Tribes demand more men. prominent tribal leaders have approached us demanding that we let them make use of the state resources to defend their lands. They claim their neighboring states are making incursions and raids into land they control, and the only efficient way to defend them is to put some of our troops under their direct command. Okay, that's great, but you lose 10 influence, or you gain 10 influence. Okay, I can't afford for them to gain 10 influence, so I'm gonna do this. So lose 20 loyalty. That sucks. I don't want disloyal tribes, but I can't let them gain 10 influence as well, because I'll put them over 80, and that's terrible. There'll be a disaster that happens. Okay, so I'm gonna say this. I'm gonna say no. They're not disloyal. You can see that's not great. I'm gonna then support the tribes with money. There, that works. Unfortunately, it cost me $30 or 30 ducats, but whatever, that's fine. Let's go and loot here. Since we can't really fight them, since they're not willing to fight us, we'll just loot everything instead. Timurids declare war on Multan. Okay. One thing we definitely want to do is look out for when Timurids start looking weak, because when they do, we want to start attacking Timurids. Oh, wait, what's happening? You want to fight me? Oh yeah, bring it on. In fact, you guys, get over here. Let's group everyone together. You want to find me there? That's not a good fight for us. Okay, they're locked. Okay, they sent an order cav. Send everyone in. This is our bad general anyway. This is a really unfortunate fight for us because it's in the mountains, and they will actually get a defense bonus because they hold the fort. That's unfortunate. There's no river between us, so they actually had to take a river crossing, I think. No, they didn't. This is a straight up bad fight for us, but we outnumber them quite a bit. Karakun has occupied Guria. Great. You know what? I'm just gonna walk into Trebizond here. We outnumber them 2-1. I think we can win. Despite the disadvantages. You can see here, because we're a horde, it says here, attacker receives 25% shock damage decrease for nomads on non-flat terrain, and we're nomads. But I think we got this. We've got this. Yeah, no problem. Cool, they're running away. Unfortunately, I'm going to leave a few cavalry behind just to keep the siege up. Which is kind of pricey. You don't really want to have to use cav for this, but that's it. I do get it. I believe being a horde, I get half price on reinforcements. Not too bad. Ottomans has declared war on Albania. That's nice. Not my problem. Although, who are you fighting? Just Albania? Serbia and Hungary. Ooh, that's interesting. We can actually try to pounce on them, except we don't share a border with them, so that's unfortunate. But if I could, Hungary. Hungary is actually a decent opponent. I mean, Ottomans will completely waste them if we check here. Sorry. Ottomans. 30,000 troops. Hungary. Oh, we don't actually know about Hungary, so we can't check how much troops they have. Unfortunate. Okay, Armenia is still being useless. Yeah, I shouldn't have been so worried about the mountains, simply because we are not them so badly. Well, you can see here, we're actually taking more damage than they are, which is slightly unfortunate. Oh, well. Oh, don't tell me you have level 3-4. Oh, wow, you have level 3-4 as well. This is stupid. So many level 3 forts. I don't like it. Okay. We are not making money, but that's fine. Ooh, Poland. They went with, let's appoint local. Oh, that's interesting. So Lithuania is going to stay as a rival for us. That's not great. Because Poland has decided to not get personal union over Lithuania. Poland, you are an idiot. But that means Lithuania's gonna get eaten up by everyone around them, probably. Well, they're ally of Poland, but still. I mean, if I was Moscovy right now, I'd be, like, jumping for joy. In fact, I actually play a game as Russia. That's actually pretty fun. Ooh, what's this? Tensions along the Erzurum border. Borders are organic things, changing and mutating with the seasons. And with fortunes of the latest conquering passing by, historians will perhaps say that the events that transpired in Erzurum in the year of our Lord, 1445, were inevitable. As Erzurum continued to flourish under the benevolent rule of Karakun, the yokels on the other side of the border were bound to get jealous. Perhaps they were less fair to us. Either way, tensions in Erzurum has given a rival neighbor a cosy belly against us. Cosy belly being cause of war in Latin. So Georgia gained a claim on Erzurum. Okay, you're not going to exist for much longer, Georgia, so whatever. In fact, can I actually... I wonder. Let's stop improving your relations. Oh, you actually declared war on Theodora. That's excellent, because... Oh, is it excellent? Where's your army? Georgia. Oh, never mind. Crimea? Where the heck is your army? Crimea? So there's Georgian army over there, which is very odd, but where the heck is the Crimean army? What is happening? Crimea. Did you get wasted? Crimea. You have 10,000 troops. Where the heck is your 10,000 troops? You're my ally, I should be able to see your troops. That is just weird. Who are you at war with exactly? Just Theodora and Trebizond. Well, Trebizond's mine, so you can't have him. You can have Theodora though. I don't care about Theodora, it's too far north. Oh well, it's not. We could try to head north as well. But yeah, seriously, where are your troops? That's kind of silly. Don't tell me you're down a ship. That just got destroyed. Please don't tell me that's the case. I don't even know what's happening right now. You can't head here because forts exert a single zone of control, so I can't walk past the fort. It's really annoying. Oh yes, anyway, peace deals. So what I'm probably going to do is how much will it take to take you out? Okay, sure. Once I take this out though, that should be still kind of difficult. It cost me 36 diplo points, that's fine. As for you, I want, I believe this was the one I need to take, Guria, but I also want to take all of this. Actually, can I vassalize you? And can I vassalize you for that matter? Because that'd be good. I can just vassalize you straight up. Okay, so that's what I'll do. I think. No. Yes, maybe. If I can vassalize you straight up, that'd be kind of nice. Yeah, because, yeah. You know what? I'll vassalize you straight up. I can still expand through Chevron. I will take this, though, just for my thing. I'll take this. And then I'll vassalize you straight up. As for Trebizond, I mean, we got a lot of diplomatic relations spots open, so it's fine. I'll vassalize you, Georgia, and I'll forcibly convert you so you hate my guts, and I'll take this while I'm at it. How much does it cost to vassalize? Cost me 0 diplo points. Excellent. Okay, so as for Trebizond, I will. I mean, how good is this province? Not bad. And I need this land border with the Ottomans, so I think I have to take you over. So I'm just gonna take you over straight up. In fact, can I do it as part of this peace deal? Okay, I can't find out yet. Well, let's keep going. I'm kind of looting the ground as I go. I don't care that we'll be taking over this ground later on, it's fine. Nothing else is happening down here. Ooh, what's happening here? You're winning a war against Moton. You're winning a war against Albania, no shit. Albania is a tiny one province minor. They're basically irrelevant in the grander scheme of things. Money. Okay, so we're slowly losing money, but that's fine, it's not much. Let's fast forward. Wow, Crimea, what the hell are you doing? Okay, there's your army. Now, finally. I wonder if I can, like, vassalize Crimea at some point. That'd be nice. Ooh, book burning. Reports have come in of a book burning taking place in Tabriz. It seems that several local religious leaders have rallied to the populace, and together they are burning all heretical literature they can get their hands on. The definition of what's heretical seems to be very broad, and looters are now even approaching several public libraries. Okay, so basically either gain piety or lose piety. So being a Muslim nation, an Islamic nation, you get this piety bar. And when you declare war, you gain piety, depending on who you declare war on, you get a whole bunch of events like this. So right now, so basically, it's quite interesting because there's actually no downsides of being pious or unpious, because either side gives you different benefits. I could actually do a mystery trip just to convert these. I mean, how much do I need to be able to convert these? Two minus two, oh wow, that's just a lot of minuses. Don't like, really don't like that. Okay, well, to having a full positive, oh, wow, sorry, having a full possible three, even that's not going to be enough, is it? I think let's go for unpious so we can get better technologies for now and more money. I can go for pious for conversions, but I really want to get the religious stuff out of the way. Okay, let's go for pious. So let's gain some piety. And I want to try to get a mystery strength up high enough. In fact, at some point, if I can, I want to get a leader who gives me more mystery strength so I can start converting these provinces from Sunni to Shia, the true Islamic faith. I'm a religious at all, by the way. What the heck? Oh, wow, Spider-Man's only 10, that's amazing. Early game, seriously, early game. Okay, let's go over here, go beat up Georgia. We probably don't need a whole army for that. Well, let's send a whole army for it anyway. Come on. You can go over there. Ooh, maybe we can get them to attack us. Nope, they're not attacking us. Fine, we're attacking them. Because if we can get more battle war skill, that'd be great. We have plenty of manpower to spare. Again, we're taking... Okay, you can see here, also, this is the way battles work. I haven't really explained it so far. Basically, you take turns rolling dice, and your leader's combat ability is kind of like an extra modifier on top of that, which is kind of nice. So we're completely wasting them, which is nice. Cool. This is going to be a pretty... Okay, we can chase them down and probably stack wipe them. Stack wipe them means we completely kill them, because you can see they ran away when they ran out of morale, the green bar being the morale bar. Let's just go finish them off. In fact, let's also merge these units, and I'm going to take the damaged units away. They can go heal up over here. By healing, I mean replenish using our manpower pool and money. We can also do the same thing with... Nah, that's fine. 25th, 26th. We're going to get there. Ooh, royal influence. With the marriage between Zhan Sa and his wife Sabah, the people of Karakun are experiencing an increased fondness for all things Crimean. With some cultural exchange was to be expected, particularly considering the popularity of the Karaman. It is with alarm that our administrative advisor, Baskur Yorkner, reports that a religious shift has been taking place in one of our provinces. What seems the influence of our Crimean Karaman trickles down even to our subjects' way of worship. In the words of the Sunni believers, have converted a surprising number of people. Ooh, that's not good. Yeah, okay. So... Samawa is Shia and is going to convert to Sunni. I kind of don't want this to become... Okay, we must denounce her of her old faith. People are slightly upset. Understandable. Let's convert. Oh, wow. Okay, we really have to become more pious to convert anything. Man, it's ridiculous. Damn you, Crimean. Ooh, stack wipe. Excellent. We stack wiped them. Okay, peace offer from Georgia. Yep, no. I'm actually going to send you over here to go help out the siege. You stay over there. Theodoro is basically gone. Karakun occupied... Okay, cool. That's good. Let's keep looting this province. Stay here for now. Just loot the place. Actually, no. Don't stay here. Go over here. Go loot there. Georgia is completely and utterly subjugated by now. I want to take our troops on at the same time, though. Let's fast forward a little more. We have a free diplomat. Can we ally Poland? Lithuania's able to go allies, but that's fine. Ally. Nope. Huge number of reasons not to. Same with you. Well, we'll keep trying. Because I need allies to be able to take on Ottomans. And probably take on Timurids. Any of you like me anymore? No, okay. Pakistan, you should become an ally. Because you're sort of big. And you don't hold any land I care about. I think. Cool. Come on, triple bond. 4. Okay, okay, not quite. I'm going to send the bulk of these guys over to here. Let's send all these cav away. Should still be enough to maintain the siege. And being a horde, we can do this really cool thing called burn down... burn province down. I'll show you in a second. Excellent. Okay, so... Muscovy, Poland. Let's come back from Poland. 23 days. You can keep looting in the meantime. 11... 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so Whoops. Can I vassalize you and take this as well? Nope. Cost too much. Okay, that's fine. Trebizond. I'm going to take your province. Cost me some different points. That's fine. People will be slightly upset, I imagine. Aggressive expansion with... No, wow, 120. I'm guessing it's mostly Trebizond. Which tells me exactly who it gains her with. Oh, well, that's fine. I don't care. I'm going to take this peace offer. Oh, I'll take your money as well. 66 ducats, because why not? Don't care about that. Cool. Okay. And then, I wonder if I can separate piece you out. Probably not. But hey, we got some money out of that, so that's good. I'm going to first... Where is the button? Raise province. Oh yeah, you gain a whole bunch of stuff from this. And then I'll call this place. Wow, wow, 94 to call. Jesus Christ, that's expensive. Okay, doesn't matter, we're calling it anyway. Yeah, that's painful. 94, that's expensive. Cool. Okay, you're free. Can I separate piece you for money? Nope, I cannot. Don't care about you then. Whoops. So I'm going to... Whoa, you're not accepting vassalization, are you? Well, that's fine. How about now? Still no. Because I need to take a province for a mission. Okay, in that case, we'll just keep looting your provinces. I mean, it's perfectly fine by me if you don't accept, you know. In the meantime, we can start planning on the next war. In fact, you two. Our next war will be against Chevron and... Tabristan probably, because you two are allied with each other. Excellent, and we need one of these trade nodes is an important thing here. I also want to start expanding this way as quickly as possible. Are you still fighting? Oh, you're losing. Oh, you're losing. Ottomans. Otto. You're running out of manpower. You're losing. Holy shit. Okay, our next war will be against the Ottomans. Jumping the gun? Probably. But the Ottomans are getting wasted here. In fact, yeah, Ottomans. Hell yes. In fact, will you be my ally? No, you won't. Damn it. Okay, we're gonna have no allies for this, but I don't care. This is a good chance to pounce on the Ottomans before they get strong. Okay, I think this is a good place to end this. It's been almost an hour. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I will see you next time for, well, more This Is Persia. I think the second one we're going to call this series. This is Persia. Until then, see you.